Do I get to say it? Is it time? Is it time? You ready? I'm ready. Hello, Legion. This is Hadrian. Thank you for being here. And welcome to my first new YouTube series of 2023, a tiny little adventure we're going to call the Against All Challenges meta series. Why meta series, you ask? This is going to be a series of series in the channel's 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time time slot. I've been playing The Long Dark since 2015, but, and this is true, I haven't touched the challenges since the game left early access in 2017. Any of them. At all. New ones, old ones, ones I've done series on, ones I haven't done series on. None of them. So you know what we're going to do, Legion? We're going to do all of them. Uncut, unedited, unadulterated, all of them. Starting with Nomad, which is a challenge I've never played, and going in order from easiest to hardest, dedicating a separate playlist in the meta-series to each one, culminating in Escape the Darkwalker and As the Dead Sleep, in that order, neither of which I've ever played. Here are the rules. If I fail a challenge, I will start over within the same playlist and try again until I succeed. Normally, that might seem like a recipe for creating a series with more than 200 episodes that never ends, which might sound great to some of you, I know. But that's why the meta-series approach is going to work so well. Each challenge will be its own series as part of a larger, ongoing effort until it's done, which means I'm likely to be at this for the next few months at least. Against All Odds Season 7 might even start in another time slot while this challenge run is still ongoing. So having said that, let me step back for just a moment. If you're brand new to the channel, or if you came to the channel while I was away and you haven't watched my live content in the past and you kind of want to know what I'm thinking with doing this first now that I'm back, first of all, let me also say thank you for the amazing response on the channel's new introduction. This is not a scripted part of my intro, but I really, really appreciate the amount of positivity that y'all have shown. It's been absolutely overwhelming and incredible, and I can't put into words how much it means to me. Anyway, not going to get all up in my feels right now. If you just want to know what I'm thinking, regardless of how long you've been here, so I've been gone a while, but I've released, in the past, 6 seasons of a Long Dark series called Against All Odds. And for my first series back, I want to do something that will help me get back into a rhythm. With the release of Tales from the Far Territory, which is the Long Dark's first ever paid DLC, 2023 is a great year to be supporting the game again. It's a fantastic year to be supporting the game again. And since I've not played these challenges in so long, what better way to wade back into daily videos than to tackle literally all of the Long Dark survival challenges, from easiest to hardest, hence Against All Challenges. And that's probably enough to give you an idea of what we're going for, and you're probably ready for some more of the Long Dark. Just to get us started off on the right foot, though, so I can be as clear as I can possibly be about this. I haven't done a data reset of any kind. I just haven't touched the challenges. I haven't even opened any of them since the game launched in 2017. I know it's hard to believe, but I have not touched them at all. Here's what's even funnier. Here I am teaching people how to play The Long Dark on YouTube, and I don't have feats unlocked. Why? Because I mostly play on custom difficulty modes. Any feat progress that you see here is from when I dip my pinky toe into Voyager or Interloper or any of the standard difficulty settings for one reason or another, but I really like to play on custom difficulty mode where you don't get feat progress. Hi, Wolf, how's it going? So, just wanted to show that before we get going, because don't want there to be any question that this is a clean slate from the very beginning, and we're going to jump in from the very beginning. So, like I said, we're going to go in order from easiest to hardest. That's going to be Nomad first, and then proceeding to Archivist second. Then we're going to jump up to the 4 acts, as opposed to 4-star. Can we just stop for a moment and listen to Sasha's score? It does not get better in gaming music, in my experience. There are others that certainly are on par and parallel it, but there are no... It doesn't get better. than music this good in games. Anyway, sorry, had to have my moment. Y'all know me. I haven't changed much, but let's go ahead and start with the Nomad Challenge. The objective of the Nomad Challenge, the world has changed. The only way to survive is to keep moving. Survive for 3 days in each of 15 specific locations across the game world. I've never done this, ever. Jennifer, hi. Sure. Against all challenges. Oh. Okay. How about just AAC? Nomad. Yeah, there we go. The world has changed. The only way to survive is to keep moving. That seems like exactly what I just read. Thank you, game. Thank you very much. Very useful for everyone. Farmhouse, Pleasant Valley. Spend 3 days at each location listed in your journal. So from what I understand, the difficulty level for this challenge is going to be Voyager difficulty level. And I have, I'll talk a little bit about how much I've played the game lately. Like, I'm not just jumping back in for the first time, playing The Long Dark for the first time, like, this entire year. I just said for the first time twice in, like, the same sentence. Do you see what I mean when I say I need to get back into the swing of things, Legion? So, I'll talk a little bit more about how much I played in a moment. But for now, spend 3 days at each location listed in your journal. All right, so what's interesting here is I don't know if it's going to give me any more information than just the names of the places. I mean, I know where these locations generally are, but in terms of what zone they're in, I know what zone they're in too, but it, like, if there were a location here where I'm like, where is that? I might have to stare at some of these. Actually, I'm looking at the list and I'm pretty confident I know where all of these are. So it seems like these are all in vanilla Long Dark zones that I'm more familiar with. The newer zones, I've played in all of them at least once, but I have very little experience in the newer zones, which is very exciting for me and hopefully exciting for you as well as we jump into a fresh series here. Hey, cup of herbal tea, nice. So, tell you what, let's go ahead and set an objective. What's the first place we're going to go? We're in Pleasant Valley right now, obviously. Of course, by the way. Can we just pause for one more moment and say, of freaking course, it puts me in Pleasant Valley to start. So the closest to us would be, I'm looking at the list, that's all Mystery Lake. Okay, so camp office through, oh, the barn. Okay, the barn might be the Pleasant Valley barn. The radio control hut might be the one on top of Signal Hill. So let's go ahead and, first of all, we need to survive for 3 days in each location. So before we go to each location, we need to have the materials that we need in order to survive. So let's do that. Scavenge up what we can find. Because this is Voyager difficulty, it's not going to be particularly challenging to find the things I need to survive 3 days. But let me not get ahead of myself. I haven't done this challenge ever. Maybe it's going to throw curveballs at me. I don't know. This will be the beginning of a glorious journey. And certainly it's going to get more and more intense as it goes along. I won't mince words. This beginning is going to be pretty ASMR. Pretty relaxing. You know, pretty laid back. Pretty straightforward in some ways. Hey, toilet water. Delicious. For now, I'm just running around and grabbing everything I can from the area. And we'll take a look at what I'm picking up. Ooh, I got a toque. Nice. All right, so there's that. There's that. Oh, wow. Those fleece mittens are in very fleece mittens. Words, Hadrian. You're going back to commentating on YouTube videos on a daily basis. Use your words. Fleece mittens. Those are in good condition. Noticing this bug from time to time when I pull up the... Yeah, they're still not showing up. There, now they're back. Okay, I just have to switch slots. So those are in really good condition to start out. Let's see what else I can find here. Ooh, tomato soup. Syrup. Very nice. Tin to pluck. Or as the gentleman who played The Long Dark when I was first becoming familiar with it would have said, a tin to plug. That was a passable imitation of a Scottish accent. Tinderplug is very, very, very Scottish. I don't remember his name now. And no, it was not Scott Manley. I remember a while back, somebody, I think it might have been might have been Patrick at Hinterland. Hi, Patrick, if you're watching. Probably not, but hi. That actually mentioned to me that it might have been Scott Manley. Scott Manley's awesome, but it was not Scott Manley that I was watching. It was just a Scott-ish person. I am moving relatively quickly right now, picking up stuff as I go, not necessarily commentating as much. That's on purpose. That's not just me being out of practice. It's because I know we are going to be playing on a lower difficulty mode, and I would like to get to where we're going sooner than later and not dally, which I suppose is the objective regardless of the difficulty you're playing on in Long Dark, right? But normally I would at least like pause and like explain some of the stuff that I'm picking up, but there's so much to grab. Oh, how did I miss those? Streamer brain, it's back. Okay, cool. Guess I'll step upstairs real quick. Already carrying a good amount. So I mentioned a moment ago that I would talk about how much I've played Long Dark lately. I have actually, in preparation for the channel coming back, which has been something that's more or less definitively planned for the last month or two at least. Like, I have known that what is happening this weekend, finally, would happen around this weekend, around the beginning of the year. And I've been playing The Long Dark again because, again, it's a fantastic time to be playing The Long Dark. It's a fantastic time to be supporting The Long Dark as a content creator. I'm very, very excited for Hinterland, and I'm very excited for the player base with the content that is to come, because it's looking like just a year of fantastic content, you know, dropping every 8 weeks or so, which... it doesn't get better than that. And I'll probably talk more, for those of you who aren't familiar with the process of how they decided on this particular strategy, the DLC and patch strategy that they're using now. I'll probably talk more about it later on, but it's just a very good time to be getting back into things. So I wanted to be not a complete rusty fool. So I wanted to, get a little bit of practice. I played a good bit on the code that will eventually be used in Against All Odds Season 7, which I've had for some time, to be honest. And I've played on it a good bit, but I hadn't played on it recently, so I played on that for a while. Ended up dying in the Forsaken Airfield, excuse me, which is the new zone, which made me sad. But at the same time, the reason I died, you'll love this, I forgot my bedroll. Even better, I didn't fully forget it. I took it with me. I went into Forsaken Airfield. I know. Half of you are already just losing your minds laughing at me. Like, of course you forgot your bedroll, Hadrian. Haven't you remembered what happened at the end of Against All Odds Season 6? Believe me, I haven't forgotten. I'm still salty about that nonsense. But I had my bedroll, okay? I had it. I want you to know that. I had it. And then I didn't. I went into one of the tunnels on the way to Forsaken Airfield. I kid you not. And because it's a long journey to the new airfield, and I was very excited to get there, but I was playing on high difficulty, while I was on the way, I needed a nap. Needed to take a little bit of a snooze. Needed to catch some rest, you know. And put my bedroll down, started a fire, had a nice little nap, recovered some condition, recovered some rest.
Well, this stuff will come in handy.
Are you freaking kidding me? The recording just passed the 10-minute mark. I know it's longer for y'all since you have the commentary at the very beginning, but wow. Urban parka. All right, cool. We got a parka, y'all. Welcome to Voyager difficulty. But so anyway, I took a nap, and then I proceeded to get up and walk away from my bedroll. And I get to Forsaken Airfield, and you can imagine my surprise when I try to grab my stuff, or I tried to get my bedroll and put it down somewhere else. And I'm like, wait, where the hell is my bedroll? And it was horrible too, because, you know, normally in situations where it's like, oh crap, I forgot my bedroll, there's that feeling of, oh, I forgot to bring it. But for me, there was this moment of, wait a minute, I did bring it. What the heck is happening? And yeah, so that's how I died in Forsaken Airfield on my highest difficulty, which I tell you that story to tell you the next one, which kind of leads back to the difficulty we're playing on now. I wanted to continue kind of re-familiarizing myself with the game and feel comfortable playing it so I could commentate without being too much of a fool while y'all are watching. And I was like, well, let me step back down to Voyager and just use it as a way of exploring the world, reminding myself of the world that I already know and love, and checking out some of the zones that I haven't been to as much. And that's one of the reasons I'm moving as quickly as I'm moving, because let me tell you something about Voyager, if you don't know. It's a lot of loot. Like, it's a lot of loot. And it's, in fact, it's so much loot. Hey, dusting sulfur, nice. That even after you just fully search one location, especially a nice, bountiful location such as the farmhouse in Pleasant Valley, thank you again so much, game, for spawning me in this wonderful zone. Appreciate you. Even after that, or I should say, especially after that, especially after arriving in a place like this, you're gonna have a ton of loot. Just one zone, especially after, you know, arriving in a particular spawning location that's this bountiful with its loot. So you have to take care to kind of look after a while. I'm not doing this right now, but you eventually get to a point where you start looking at what you're picking up. But I don't want to say what I just said and assume that that means I'm going to just plow through this challenge, because again, there might be some curveball in store for me. But oh, wait a minute. Did I just see metal container? Yes, I did. Also, I think I picked up a lantern earlier while I was blabbing. I did. Hey. How about some light? Would you like to see things in my recording? There you go. Simple torch. Let's see. Orange soda. Good. So I played a good bit on Voyager difficulty lately, and I actually ended up designing a custom code, which I can share in chat if y'all would like me to. Or share, can you tell I've been spending time on Twitch? I can share in the comments, this is YouTube, if y'all would like me to. It's basically a custom Voyager mode that removes some of the more annoying aspects of playing for like the long term on Voyager difficulty. If you like Voyager, but like some of the, just the insane amount of loot starts to bother you after a while. Hang on, I'm double checking because streamer brain. It's been a while since I've been this talkative while playing this game at all, so I just want to make sure I'm not overlooking anything, he said as he kept talking. Okay. All right, so there's the reclaimed wood. Looks like a little bit more cloth. Very good. Reclaimed wood. Trail boots. Oh, hey, heavy hammer. Nice. I doubt I'm going to be using that, to be honest. I kind of know where I'm going, and I just need to take care of myself. Speaking of that, and speaking of things that I need to bring with me everywhere. Yes, I already have a bedroll. Of course I do, because this is Voyager difficulty, and it gives you one. Because it's nice, as opposed to future difficulty levels. All right, I'll grab those fleece mittens too. We're already encumbered. We're already carrying way too many things, and we haven't even left the house. We haven't even gone outside. We spawned in the farmhouse, and it's just... See, I haven't even searched these cabinets. What's wrong with me? This is why I double-check things. And this is why we're doing a super easy challenge as I jump back into YouTube content, because holy crap. The amount of stuff that I have already overlooked in one episode. This can't happen. This can't be. This cannot be, Legion. We have to hold ourselves, and by ourselves, I mean myself, to high standards. I think that's everything. It's about midday. Let's step outside and actually see what things look like, because we need to at least see if the barn that's mentioned is the one that I think has been mentioned. And yes, I know there's probably somewhere in there I didn't fully search. Let me just go ahead. I know I've beaten this dead horse already, but I'm going to do it again. We're playing on Voyager difficulty. This is the easiest challenge. So, probably gonna be okay not thoroughly searching every last container like we're playing on Interloper difficulty or on some Against All Odds code. Probably gonna be fine. Hey, a pry bar. Ooh, you know what I might do? Since I've got the pry bar now, I might go and open that locker in the basement real quick since I'm still right here. Yeah, let's do that. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go back down and... Hi. Where are you? I mean, I'm not super concerned about you. Because easy mode, but still, hi. Oh, that door just rudely smacked me in the face. Another ragged wool toque. Very nice. I can replace that cap that I'm wearing with the 27% condition and yet still better than the baseball cap I was wearing. Wow. Wow. Let me make sure that I'm wearing the best items I can here. I did get another pair of wool socks. Indeed, I did. There we go. Looks like these are... Yeah, about the same. So I have two 61% pairs of wool socks. Yeah, work boots are still better than trail boots in some ways. Work boots are more restrictive of movement. So I could put on the trail boots. They'd be light. They're also lighter. They'd be lighter. The condition would be better. I mean, granted, I can repair the work boots, so condition isn't really a thing. Just doing a strict comparison of what I'm carrying. I've got two 92% pairs of work boots as well, or trail boots. So picked up a few duplicate items. Let me go ahead and we're going to pick up this jerry can, which, yes, I did see it. Let's go ahead and drop one of those. And you know what? I'm going to go ahead and wear them. I'm going to wear them because I'll lose a little bit of warmth protection from that, but you have to understand... The work boots are heavier, so getting rid of those is kind of a net positive right now. We're at the very beginning, and we already have an urban parka. I can afford to wear slightly less absurd footwear, to put it mildly. Okay, so I can repair a few things as well. Let's go ahead and do that just for the sake of being thorough. And before it gets too dark... I am going to head down and check on that locker, and then we're going to go to the barn and see if that is in fact the location I'm supposed to be at. Because again, I want to move somewhat rapidly through this. Let's refuel, and then I will probably just drop that jerry can right here. Yep. Might even drop the heavy hammer, because am I going to use it? No, let's be honest, I'm not. Why do I need to use it? Also, I think I just drank water, so why did I just try to drink it again? I don't need that many antiseptics. I'm not going to be this disorganized. I'll at least put stuff in a box. How about that? That's better. And now I'm no longer encumbered. Imagine that. Oh, the snow stopped. Okay, let's head downstairs real quick. Relatively straightforward stop here. A little dark, I know, here. I'll give you a light. Anything? Anything? Maybe?
I'll take it.
Hey, worn ski gloves and a decent thin wool sweater. That is an improvement. Now the question is, I think... Yeah, actually, the decent plaid shirt might be even a little better than the decent hoodie, if I'm not mistaken. But the decent hoodie provides a little bit better protection. So I might leave, since it's in better condition too, let me go ahead and replace the plaid shirt for now. I'll repair that up before I drop it completely. I think I'll probably just drop that. I'll keep a few more items on me. I just don't want to get encumbered again. Because that's going to happen relatively quickly once I start finding things in this. All right, let's go visit the barn and see if I'm right. Because that's going to be the main challenge with this particular challenge, is looking at the list of places that I need to go and thinking, do I know where this is? Do I know which particular locations this is talking about? So I'm reasonably certain that I recognize every item on that list, but I have never done this challenge before, so I don't know for sure. And I don't know what kind of craziness might be in store. But I'm going to assume minimal craziness, and therefore move at a reasonable clip through this one. And for those of you wondering, with regard to the other challenges and the ones that I've done and haven't done, I've done Nomad, and I've done The Hunted, Part 1 and 2, the original versions of them. I haven't done the retooled challenges, so it's really been a while for me. Hey, some dough, which are in the game now as part of the free updates that have been added. Those free updates coincide with Tales from the Far Territory, which has been, again, a fantastic just moment for the Long Dark. It's been great to see the game step into the DLC space and the expansion space, because you know the game has existed as a paid unit and story mode game, so story-based and survival-based game. It started as just story mode. For those of you who don't know, the plan was to have a story-based experience. They created a sandbox just to help test the survival mechanics. The sandbox was so well done, the survival mechanics were so intuitive and fun, that the sandbox became a fun game in its own right. And that has continued for Hinterland to such a degree that it is now its own separate SKU, its own separate little product number on the Steam website for you to download. You can get the survival mode separately. So you can still, if you've bought The Long Dark in the past, you can still play the story mode, the complete story mode, when it comes out, episode 5 still to be released, which will be the final episode, and you'll still get free updates. But they've, in order to continue supporting the game, and in order to continue supporting the studio as they develop new games and continue to do awesome things, there is the added bonus of this Tales from the Far Territory DLC that they've released this year, which, again, a number of updates to go with the paid DLC, and then a number of free updates that coincide with them, one of which was the deer that we walked by, or the doe, rather, which is a deer. It's a female deer. We know this because of the song. All right, so I think that's the barn that I'm supposed to survive in for 3 days. Oh, that's nice. When you pull up the context menus, it shows your objective. Well, that's the broad objective. There's a part of me that wishes I could put a more specific objective on the screen, but that's good. That shows how often I play the challenge modes, because I don't even know what, like, the little differences that are in the game, especially with the current interface. Long Dark's interface has changed a couple of times while the game has been in development, and I have not touched these challenges in a hot second. So, let's go ahead and just go in this door. Please say barn. Oh, yay. Okay. So I'm in the barn. I know it's the barn because it says barn. It also says Pleasant Valley, but it says barn. List says barn. Screen says barn. Barn, 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 barn. So let's search this place up, because again, there's going to be stuff everywhere. I'm telling you, Voyager difficulty, like, I enjoy it as a way of refamiliarizing myself with the world and also experiencing the world on in a more casual way, because the Long Dark has a beautiful, you know, landscape, and I enjoy just being in it from time to time and not fearing for my life on a second-to-second basis. That's kind of nice from time to time, but so much loot. So I'm going to do what I can to keep that in mind with this series and not spend too much time doing inventory management, because that, if anything, from a content perspective, watching me play, that's what'll be different, is since I haven't played a lot on Voyager, apart from the Survival School series, which I was just reminded a few days ago when I did Survival School 2018, I used the Voyager difficulty. Aside from that series, I play on custom difficulty or comparable, at least Stalker, in most of my series. So this much loot is insane, especially at the rate at which I tend to go through and find stuff, as y'all have been seeing. All right, so candy bar that's half blended in the floor. Cool. 3 revolver cartridges. anything under the safes. For those of you who were not aware, who haven't played The Long Dark recently, one of the really cool things that coincided with the first free update of the Tales from the Far Territory. Hey, Firestriker, that's a good early find. I like it. One of the first things that was added is they refreshed all, everywhere, every zone, not just for this challenge, but for the entire game, all of the loot tables. So, yeah. Everything you think you know about where things are in the Long Dark, that knowledge is gone. Start over. Have fun. Especially if you play on high difficulty. So that makes it more interesting for us. And one thing that'll be coming soon, which, again, I'm going to continue talking about Tales from the Far Territory because it's just what I do. And it's a really good time to be talking about the Long Dark, playing the Long Dark, supporting the Long Dark. But one of the things that they're going to be adding soon, maybe not in the next update, it's not confirmed, but like in one of the coming updates as part of Tales from the Far Territory, well, this will be a free component, but again, it'll coincide with Tales from the Far Territory's content release, is they're refreshing the enemy spawns, so the creatures and the wildlife spawns that appear. I guess wildlife would be the best way to describe it. They're refreshing all of that too, so wherever you're used to seeing bears and wolves, that's all gonna change too. Ain't that gonna be fun? Also, guess what? You can finally find things in visors, guys. And girls. You can find visors. You can find things in visors. Of course you can find visors. You've always been able to find visors. But the point is, you can find visors. And things in them. Together. And occasionally, those things are pretty fun. Specifically, they're types of kind of surprise caches that you can discover. So, one of the things that I have changed in the aforementioned code for a custom difficulty mode for, what's this? Voyager. I don't know why I couldn't remember Voyager for a moment. But one of the things that I've changed is you tend to lose exhaustion pretty quickly in this mode. But in this case, I think it will actually kind of work in our favor because it'll allow us to pass time a little bit faster. So let me take a moment here, now that we're settled into the barn and I've mostly searched the place up. Let me take a moment just to go through the things that I have and make sure that I've kind of, that I'm carrying the things I need to carry. What I'm going to do, this is often when I'm managing a lot of inventory. Again, I'm going to try to minimize this in these lower difficulty playthroughs while we're in the early part of Against All Challenges as much as possible. But it is good to also explain inventory management practices, like best practices, for those who may be less familiar with the game. So you've got these sorting options, and sometimes if I'm repairing clothes like you saw me do earlier, I will sort by condition, and then that way I can have the stuff that's lowest. If you click the icon repeatedly, it'll switch back and forth. But if you select by weight and then go category by category, you can look at this number in the upper right-hand corner of each tab, and you can see how much is being taken up by that particular category. So right now, I'm carrying a ton of food and drink. I'm also carrying a lot of tools. I don't need 3 flares. I'll probably drop that. I don't need that much scrap metal, although I can't recall. Can I? Yes, I can. I can repair with scrap metal. I can repair this storm lantern. So let's go ahead and at least do that. This will be a way to pass time without sleeping. Okay, let's do the same thing again. Okay, so now that's completely repaired. I used some of that scrap metal to do it, so that also helped shed some of the weight that I was carrying, and I no longer have any scrap metal on me. I'm going to... Oh, hello. It got dark while I was doing that. Nice. I'm going to step over here and put down all the firewood I found, because we're going to be here for a moment. And, yep, also have this. So as I was saying, you can sort things by weight, but then also go category by category, and you can spot just at a glance, like, how much is each category taking up space in your stuff. And you can target the categories that maybe you need to prune the most in terms of what you're carrying, which is exactly what I'm doing now. Food is definitely a problem. It's more or less the only problem now. Although I'm also carrying 7 books. That is completely and utterly unnecessary. So let's drop maybe all but one of those for now. Yeah, and there goes the sprain risk. Perfect. I'm going to drop. I'll keep that one book on me. Drop that, drop that. And I frankly don't even need this many matches. So what I'll do is I will drop the cardboard matches. Drop those cardboard matches. Keep the wood matches. Drop those as well. I don't need that many wood matches. You know what? I've got a fire striker. What am I doing? Go away. I don't even need that thing. So what I want to do is I want to see if, like, because I still don't know for sure that I'm in the right barn. I mean, I know I did the whole back and forth thing earlier, but I don't really, really. I was looking right. There it is. There's the fire barrel, which means the bedroll's right there. Perfect. Sorry. Almost thought I was going to have to light my lantern again just to find my way around in the dark. But it's fine. We're okay. Let's go ahead and sleep for... Hold that thought. Let's drink some water. Now, let's go ahead and sleep for 9 hours. 9 hours. Straightforward. Woke up fully rested. The night is still ongoing, and I am in the correct location. So, with that as a save point, and with us also being at approximately the 36, 37 minute mark, I don't remember exactly how long my beginning commentary was. But anyway, since we're about that point, I will go ahead and stop this first episode here. And in the next one, we'll continue this challenge. Once I've kind of gotten my momentum going, we are going to move through these locations relatively quickly. So that we're not dallying too much in the Nomad challenge. But for those of you who don't know very much about the world of the Long Dark and don't mind the spoilage of where some of these locations are, the guidance might be useful for you. So feel free to watch along, play along, and ask questions as they come up. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, it's my first one in a very long time, so please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to follow along. New episodes are going to be coming out every day at 1 p.m. U.S. Eastern Time. Comments are always welcome. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you next time. Which won't be 2.5 years this time. Okay, bye.